The one and only Michael Strahan joins us here on Radio Boss. He is Miles Truitt. He joins us here on Radio Boss. What's going on, Miles?
I need you to introduce me more, man. I love that, man. That was good. That was good.
Stephen A. Smith. He joins us once again here on BOXTOROW. He's an 8-time tag team champion. Main event. Jey Uso joining us here on the program.
Right on. It was appreciate the introduction, man.
Nia Jax, known as the Irresistible Force, 1-time Raw Women's Champion, 2-time WWE Women's Tag Team Champion, joining us here on the program. She's a grad of Mississippi Valley State, a former 3-time All-Pro in the National Football League with the New England Patriots, has had many stops in his coaching career. Welcome the new head football coach, North Carolina A&T, Vincent Brown, to the program. Right now, we have joining us who I think may be the best player in all of HBCU football. He is the quarterback for North Carolina Central. He is Davis Richard. Listen, when you can have a legendary figure on your show 2 times, you're doing something. We talked with her back in 2014. She's the one and only Dionne Warwick. Joins us here on BOXTOROW with the Radio Boss. In his first season as the general manager of the Detroit Lions, he is Brad Holmes. He joins us here on BOXTOROW. It's been a long time, Brad. Good to see you. Welcome to the program. Welcome to another edition of BOXTOROW's Countdown to 20. I'm your host, Donald Ware, and today we're going to take a look back at a conversation with one of the biggest stars of the WWE, Bianca Belair. So, growing up, I was a huge wrestling fan, really, and as I've kind of gotten older, when my children were kind of coming up, and I would watch wrestling with them, and then we would kind of move on from it, but once WWE SmackDown came to Fox, I was like, wow, this is pretty big time. Now you're talking about network television. So I started watching wrestling again. And even during the pandemic in 2020, it was a little strange because you didn't have the crowds and whatnot. But in terms of watching SmackDown on Friday night, you know, Bianca Belair really caught my attention with her athleticism and so forth, and then she became one of the biggest stars. So, of course, I was tuning in each and every week and then really got back into wrestling. Of course, you had a lot of other wrestlers and whatnot. And then the pinnacle was when she took on Sasha Banks for the WrestleMania, as a matter of fact, in 2022. And really, really big show. First time that two black women had faced off against each other for the women's title. And it was an honor definitely to catch up with Bianca Belair. So I think with this conversation with Bianca Belair, you're going to learn a lot about her, not only in terms of wrestling, but also she was an all-SEC track and field performer. So enjoy the conversation with the one and only Bianca Belair as BOXTOROW celebrates 20 years on the air. Let's continue here on BOXTOROW with the Radio Boss, and got a special guest on the line. I'm going to tell you, like, I'm a wrestling fan, right? But Friday Night SmackDown, one of the main reasons I watch SmackDown on Friday night is because of my guest, known as EST, and as a matter of fact, the WWE Royal Rumble champion. She is Bianca Belair, joins us here on BOXTOROW with the Radio Boss. EST is in the building. What's going on, Bianca?
Hey, 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 how are you?
Doing good. I'm glad to have you on. You know, I see your star rising, and it's interesting because right before you won the Royal Rumble, that Friday, something was different about not necessarily you, but the whole setup. It seemed like you were the star of that show Friday night. So it was no surprise when I found out Sunday that you won it.
Your thoughts on winning that Royal Rumble?
Man, that was just an amazing night. You know, it was a whirlwind of emotions. I remember being in the ring and actually winning the Royal Rumble and having the feeling of, oh, I'm the last woman standing out of 30 women across three different brands, Raw, NXT, and SmackDown, and Legends. I just won this Royal Rumble. And then looking to the left and seeing the WrestleMania sign, and it hit me afterwards that, oh, yeah, that means you're going to WrestleMania. So it was like I knew that if you won the Royal Rumble, you were punching your ticket to WrestleMania. But when you're in the Royal Rumble, it's such a long and grueling match that, you know, you're trying to throw people over the top rope and someone's trying to throw you over the top rope that you can't think about too many things at once. So when I finally won, that was the only thing that was in my mind was, hey, I just won. This is great. And then I looked to the left and I'm like, oh yeah, I'm going to Mania. This is amazing. So I was on cloud nine and just, I was vulnerable in that moment and, you know, all this tough exterior of I'm the EST and I'm strong and I'm the strongest and the toughest and the roughest and the quickest and the greatest and the best. All that just came tumbling down and I would just cried and I thought about my mom and my dad in the moment. So I shouted them out. And I think that's what I let everyone in and everyone felt like they were a part of the moment with me, which is what I love about that moment.
56 minutes in the ref. I mean, no matter what you're doing, that's a long, and we'll talk more about that. That's where your track training comes into play, right? We'll talk a little bit more about that. But like your parents were super excited for you, right? Like so I saw a video, something your dad said or something happened there, right?
Oh yeah, my parents are my biggest supporters. They've been riding with me for, you know, forever. But my dad, he's just the person, like ever since I ran track, I have track videos where he's recording and I would cross the finish line. All of a sudden the camera would go up in the sky because he would just like fall back and pass out. So it's been a thing. I used to always tweet about how my dad would like fall over the back of the couch when like the show came on or my entrance would come on and no one believed me. So I was able to get them to record themselves because they come to every single big moment and they weren't able to for Royal Rumble. So I had them record themselves because I wanted to see them watch it. And I just could not believe it that they caught my daddy falling over the back of the couch because he was so excited about the Royal Rumble. And he stood up on the table. My mom was like yelling, point to the sign, girl, point to the sign. So they get really hype and really like into it. And I love them for that.
That, of course, the voice of Bianca Belair, EST, is in the building. She joins us here on BOXTOROW with the Radio Boss. As a matter of fact, you can see her Fridays on SmackDown on Fox. And 1 week from today, she will be, of course, at WrestleMania taking on Sasha Banks. So we very much look forward to that as well. To talk about that, and you know, because this is the thing, like I've been watching wrestling a long time and there have been black wrestlers, but not a lot of black female wrestlers. So, I mean, it's you, it's Sasha Banks. You guys are tight. There's others, obviously. But what does that mean to you to be one of the stars right now as a black woman in WWE?
It's an amazing feeling. The best word I could say is I just feel blessed, like super blessed. Not even just lucky. I just feel blessed to know that I'm going into WrestleMania to face Sasha Banks, who is the boss, the blueprint, the standard. She is all of those things. And I'm able to, you know, being in WWE, your dream is to make it to WrestleMania, to be in WrestleMania. And the fact that I'm going there, I'm going to be on the grandest stage of them all with Sasha Banks at Tampa Bay on April 10th. It's amazing. And knowing that, you know, WrestleMania is already just, it's the biggest event of the year. You know, how can you possibly make WrestleMania even bigger? It's just like, well, creating history at WrestleMania. And that's what Sasha Banks and I are going to do. We're going there to WrestleMania. We're going to create history. We're going to be the first two black females to have a title match at WrestleMania, which is amazing. And I always say representation is not a request, it's a requirement. And we're going there to try to become, I'm going there to try to become SmackDown Miss Champion, but it's more than just creating a moment and becoming a champion. Just by us standing in the ring, We are representation for women, representation for Black women. And so that's an amazing feeling to be able to be that person and be on that platform on the grandest stage of them all and be able to create history. It's an honor. And I just can't wait to be in that moment and finally be in front of fans. We're getting fans back for the very first time in over a year. We'll have 25,000 fans each night. And we're following all safety protocols. We're doing pods and social distancing, masks required. We're doing PSAs telling people, you know, everyone wants to get back to normal. So like roll up your sleeves, do your part, get vaccinated. And that's what we're doing. We're trying to get back to normal with WrestleMania and just being able to be on that platform with Sasha Banks. It's going to be a magical night, and to be able to create history and be representation, it just brings so much more purpose to WrestleMania.
No question. For you, talk about your meteoric rise. Like, I mean, what was it? Maybe three years ago, you were in NXT, but you've gone. I mean, you've just continued to rise and rise to the point that now, I mean, you're one of the most popular wrestlers on Friday Night SmackDown, and it's on Fox, by the way. That's, I mean, I can't even speak about how huge that is. I mean, cable's cool, but Fox, that's network television.
Yeah, when I actually got drafted to SmackDown last year, so I've been on SmackDown less than a year, and so it's crazy to think that being on SmackDown for less than a year, I'm already going to WrestleMania, and you know I was in NXT since 2016, and it's crazy sometimes like seeing myself on a WrestleMania poster. Because I think about like the greats like Undertaker and Shawn Michaels and The Rock and Steve Austin. Like I remember seeing them on these WrestleMania posters, and now that I'm on the WrestleMania poster, I'm like, is this the same WrestleMania? Like, this is the same thing. I'm on this level with them. So it's been a wild and fun and crazy ride ever since I came into WWE since 2016. You know, I have a very unique journey. I didn't watch wrestling growing up, or I didn't dream of being a WWE wrestler when I was 10. Wrestling found me, and it's completely changed my life around. So to be someone who never imagined being a WWE wrestler, now I am a WWE wrestler, and I can't imagine myself doing anything other than this now, because I've just completely fallen in love with WWE, and I'm so passionate about it. So it's I just feel blessed to be the one in this position to be at WrestleMania. To now be on Fox, which is a big deal. You know, they say SmackDown is a land of opportunity. And I think that I've proven that true ever since I've gotten to SmackDown. I've been going up, up, up all the way to WrestleMania now.
No question. You know, a couple of years ago, I had Alexa Bliss on the show. I asked her, well, how does one go from being a cheerleader in college to WWE and at the top of the game? So I'm going to ask you the same question. How does one go from being a track star to WWE?
I say for me, it's just all about starting over every single day and moving forward. You know, I ran track in college. I did CrossFit. I did gymnastics, tumbling, soccer, almost every sport in the book. And I'm not any of those things right now. But those things led me to where I am now, you know, track and CrossFit. And Mark Henry discovered me doing CrossFit. All of those things led to where I am now. So it's all about moving forward. And I always say, whenever what's going to be for you is going to be for you. No one can take that away, but you have to make sure that you put yourself in a position where when that opportunity presents itself, that you're prepared for it. So I always say, you never know who's watching you. So you always got to show up and show out, even when you don't think anyone's watching you. Because I was doing CrossFit and I had no idea Mark Henry was going to see a video of me. But I was showing up and I was showing out. I was moving forward. I was trying new things. And for me, I didn't know that wrestling was my dream. And so I had to just keep moving forward and opening myself up, making sure I was available for any opportunity that came my way. And that's what happened for me. And when Mark Henry contacted me and asked me, had I ever thought of being a WWE wrestler? You know, I was like, this is either too good to be true or this is the perfect fit for me. But he also was very adamant on, I can get you a tryout, but I cannot get them to hire you. I can't get them to like you. You have to do that. You have to do that for yourself. So for me, it was just, you know, this is the opportunity and I have to move forward and I have to go in and give 100%. And, you know, for some people, you know, they knew that wrestling was their dream. And so they just stuck with it and they kept going after it no matter what. For me, it was just something where I say, you just keep moving forward. Just always keep moving forward. You never, whatever direction you go, you want to go for it, because you're eventually going to get to your destination, and whatever's going to be for you is going to be for you, and it will find you. But you have to be ready for that opportunity.
Yep. No question about it. The one and only BEST joins us here on the program. So, I mean, you were a pretty good track star though, right? Like I believe all American in the SEC, right?
Oh yeah. University of Tennessee.
Yeah. I mean, so that's the home, cause you're from that. So that's the hometown school. Can you speak to that and being able to be a star at the hometown school?
Yeah. So I ran track in high school and I got a full scholarship. I actually started out at the University of South Carolina for my freshman year. Then I transferred to Texas A&M University. And then I finished up at the University of Tennessee, which is my hometown. I was born and raised in Knoxville, Tennessee. So I went back home and it was cool because my mom also graduated from the University of Tennessee. So, being back home and, you know, I was kind of a hometown, I don't know what word to call it, but when I was in high school, like I was very popular because I was very good in sports and I was the number one recruit out of high school going into college. So to be able to come back home and finish up and be very successful at the University of Tennessee in my hometown with a community that's been behind me ever since I was a little girl. I was surrounded by love with my community and they pushed me and motivated me. And so to go back home and finish it up there in that community, it's, you know, Knoxville is my home, it's my heart, and I'm always going to be a Lady Vol for life. So that's till the day I die.
Yeah. Couple of more thoughts. What are we going to see from you and Sasha Banks next week, you know, at WrestleMania? And you're right, like WrestleMania is huge. I can remember going back to way, you know, back in the day and all that. But what do we need to expect from the both of you?
Well, all I can say is things are heating up between Sasha and I. I think, you know, there's no friendship on the line. All that there is on the line is a title that I want from Sasha and a title that Sasha doesn't want me to have. And so it's just two alpha females that are going in there to compete, to prove, you know, Sasha calls herself the best. I call myself the BEST, the best. And it's going to be two women in there, you know, going for the same goal, competing, fighting, and really trying to prove who is actually the best. And, you know, she calls me the rookie. So I know she's going to be in there trying to not let this rookie take that title from her. So it's going to be a magical two nights. And it's going to be amazing. And for all the fans that are going to be there, the 25,000 fans are going to be there. And also for everyone watching, that's going to be watching on Peacock, because WrestleMania is going to be streaming live on Peacock for the first time ever. But it's going to be a magical night. It's not just going to be about the match. It's like WrestleMania is about the gear, the entrance, the show. So we're just going out there to put on the show and create history.
Absolutely. The one and only Bianca Belair, EST, joins us here on BOXTOROW with the Radio Boss. Again, you can check her out each Friday on SmackDown on Fox. And also next week, WrestleMania 37 is absolutely huge. Bianca, appreciate the time. Continued success in all you do.
Thank you so much for having me.